In the credit card class, we can look at the pseudocode and find that it first sets sum and count to zero. That's already there. These lines are the same as what we had before for computing the sum of every other digit. The for each digit starting from the right part is getting pretty familiar now. I'll keep the code for controlling the number of iterations in place. But now instead of just always adding digit to the sum, I need to check whether the count is even or odd. And before I even get the digit, I'll want to make sure I remember to increment count. Now, if count is odd, I add the digit to the sum. Otherwise, count is even, and if the digit is less than 5, I add twice the digit to the sum. In the last case, count is even, and the digit is greater than 5, and I want to add twice the digit, and then subtract 9. This is all just matching that pseudocode. Now, instead of just returning false, I need to return whether the last digit of n is 0 or not. The last digit of n is 0 when sum mod 10 is 0. For example, if sum were 24, then sum mod 10 would be 4, which is not 0, and the card would not be valid. But if sum is 40, then sum mod 10 is 0, and the card is valid. So this would return true. Looks like I forgot to change my pseudocode into real code. Count is odd if count mod 2 is 1. And now I'll run the tester. And it looks like, for at least the examples that we've used, my code is returning true when true is expected, and false when false is expected. Here's some food for thought. Does this guarantee that my code is correct?